let's go ahead and create a new user in our organization. So to create a new user, I just have to go under Add a User, and I'm now in the new user interface. Now, remember that we're using the Microsoft 365 Admin Center, but what I'm going to be doing now is actually creating a user account in Azure Active Directory. So this is a security principle or a user that will be able to authenticate to my subscription, my tenant. So I'm going to call this user Zachary. Let me make sure I give him a last name. And I'm going to give him a username. I don't have any rules for username, so I'm just going to give him his first name as his alias. And then the domain name is going to be used to populate his overall username for sign-in information. I can also specify now the location, so the location is relevant for licensing. Then I can click under contact information. None of the information here is required. These are all information that I can add for search purposes or cataloging or reporting or HR purposes. If later on you want to find all users that are located in the city of Montreal, then you can just populate the city of Montreal for all your user accounts and then search for them. If it's important for you to find all users that are in the marketing department separately, you can also put that as a department value. These are all stored as attributes, and these attributes are populated in Azure Active Directory for all of the user accounts, and they can be used again for search fields. Then I can specify here a password. Now the password can either be auto-generated or I can create the password manually. So I'm going to go ahead and create the password manually for this user account. And I have the option to make the user change his password at first sign-in, which I'm not going to do. If I do that, as soon as they sign in, they will be required to put in a new password. It's usually a best practice if you're creating a password for someone else for them to go ahead and change that password after. Then under the roles here, I can specify the administrative roles. Now, you have two primary options here, a user, which means this individual does not have any administrative access, or you have global administrator. Now, global administrator means that they have full access over the Office 365 environment. They can purchase services, they can purchase licenses, they can add domain names, they can remove other user accounts, they can do essentially anything they want. And then we have the customized administrators. Customized administrators are essentially custom roles that have been created in Office 365 that have a subset of rights that are very specific. For example, you have a right which is the Exchange administrator. And this basically means that the user has the ability to manage, implement, modify all the Exchange-related settings in my tenant. You have also a role called Billing Administrator, which is someone that has only the right to purchase licenses. They can manage the objects, but they can purchase licenses for your organization. You have also a Message Center Reader. Somebody can read all the notifications or the service health issues that come from Microsoft about your tenant and your subscription. So you see that these are very, very specific, and you can assign multiple of these custom roles, or you can assign none of them. Now, I will choose to make him a simple user with no administrative access. Then I have the ability to assign licenses. Now, you'll notice that by default, there are no licenses, and you have an option at the bottom, which is to create a user without any product licenses. And I don't want to do that because I want this user to have access to resources in Office 365. The most common license is, again, an Office 365 license that provide access to email services and OneDrive and so on. So I'm actually going to give that license to the user. You notice that I have one license available because I've purchased one license. So I'm going to click on the toggle here to assign the license. And then I can turn on or off various workloads inside of the license. And that's the license I'm adding. I'm going to click on Add, and the license is being added to the user. I can click Close, and this user now has been created, has been provided a license, and that license has been provided also various services. So let's go ahead and try to sign in with that user. So I'm going to sign out from my user account. And I'm going to try to sign in again, even though it's usually better to close all the browser windows. Sometimes it will let me sign in without closing my browser windows. So I'm going to try again on office.com. And I'm going to click on sign in, and I'm going to switch to a different account. It's remembering me, but I want to switch to a different account. And that's going to be the account I just created. And it's prompting me for that password again. And now I'm signed in under Zachary's account. Now, being signed in under Zachary's account, here I can verify that I'm signed in for Zachary's account. I signed a license for Zachary, and now he has access to all these various applications. And he can click, for example, on Outlook or OneDrive, and he can go ahead and create email messages, send email, receive emails, just by signing in here to his account.